Starting off, past district governor Mike Simonini and Lion president Jane. Next, one-year director Kevin O'Neill. One-year director Ed Musa and Lady Maggie. Two-year director, Mohammed Baloum. Two-year director, Laura Pellegrini, Bishi, and Bob. Our historian, past president Bruce Sutter.
Oh, here we go.
Past President Gary Pellegrini and Lady Mary Ellen. Lion Tamer, past President John Muniz and Lady Patty. Lion Tamer John Hipley and Lady Lolly. Lion Oscar Loza and Lady Dolores. Oh, Lynn! Hi, past president. Lynn Clinton is here. The tallest man in the room, our treasurer, Lion Calvin Shin. Our secretary, Lion John Celentano and Lady Elaine. Our second vice president, past president Ron Frediani and Lady Carol. Our first vice president, Ryan Michael Kelly, and his partner in service, Amy. Everybody be attentive because our immediate past president, but he's still current president. His future position will be immediate past president. We appreciate everything he did. Lion Steve Henderson. Lady Cindy is with him, and they are coming forward. Please, everybody, take a look. Wow. Our international director, Lion Ken Ibera, and our past president, Lion Randy Sahai. Everybody, please stand and continue standing for our district governor, Lion John Huey, and our PCL past president, Manisha Young. And last, but not least, our incoming president, Lion Bill Meyer and Lady Carol. Thank you, everybody. We appreciate your presence. Please take your seats.
Color guard, attention. Color guard, advance. Color guard, hold. Color guard, prepare to post the colors. Post the colors. Please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Two. Color guard dismissed.
My country, 'tis of thee, sweet land of liberty, of thee I sing. Land where my fathers died, land of the pilgrim's pride, from every mountainside, everybody. My country, 'tis of thee, sweet land of liberty, of thee I sing. Land where my fathers died, land of the pilgrim's pride,
for helping us.
As we begin this evening together, may you give wisdom and grace in our dealings with each other, others in our restrictive organizations, and those we come in contact with tonight. Also help us to see the many good things around us and ways and can be a blessing. To someone we encounter tonight, help our words to be positive, and those instances where there may be corrective, clear, and easy, and seasoned with humility rather than arrogance and destruction. Thank you, and amen.
Okay. If all you non-Lions, I am Gary Pellegrini. I'm the immediate past president. I was president before Steve Henderson. And first of all, I would like to recognize and thank the committee that put this event on. So Wayne Lee, past president Wayne Lee. Incoming First Lady Carol Meyer. Sharon Lee, I believe she has left the building, right? And yours truly, I had a hand in this as well. I had a hand in these little obnoxious guitars that you're gonna put on. So, and then yes, and this too. Thank you very much. Let's see. So yes, and I really have to give a huge thanks to Wayne. Wayne really pulled this whole thing together. So I really appreciate that, Wayne. So this coming year, I'm going to be the parliamentarian, and I think parliamentarian has something to do with the rules and regulations. So I can break them as I go along. So I do want to wish a happy 57th anniversary to past District Governor Mike Simonini and his beautiful bride, Jane, 57 years tomorrow. Yes, you do. So does she. And before I go on with the introductions, I talked to past president Paul Larson, and he said this was perfectly fine to do this. We're starting another year under Bill, but we also finished another year under Lion Steve Henderson, and Steve, you did a wonderful, wonderful job this past year. So I got to hand it to you. Yes. So, but we have also lost three of our Lions family. So I would like to mention their names and just have a, you know, a brief moment of silence for them, because they really stepped up to the plate during their years in Lionism. First off is Bob George. I did not know Bob, but I hear all these wonderful stories that he was so involved with Lionism and did the Christmas tree lot and such. So I wish I actually got to know him, but I did not. Second is past president Al Mirando. We all loved Al Mirando. I mean, he was one of the reasons I joined this club, along with George Habib and Art Pignotti. And I can't say enough about Al. And then most recently, Lady Celia Pignotti. And I went to her services on Wednesday. It was a beautiful service, but we're all going to miss her. We're all going to miss all three of them. So a brief moment of silence for those three. Okay, I'm sure they're looking down and saying this is okay. So are there any other club presidents in the room? If they are here, please stand. All right. Very good. Thank you for being here. All right. Now, if you would please hold your applause until I am done with this list, I'm going to introduce a lot of officers from our District 4. First is past District Governor Mike Simonini. Past District Governor Macy Mack. Global Service Coordinator Lion Jimmy Ness, who is our DJ for the evening. Leo District Chair, our own Michael Kelly. Zone 1 Region 4 Chair Wayne Lee. Region 4 Chair Mariah Tucker. 4C4 Executive Officer Lion Denise Kelly. 4C4 Secretary Lion Yvonne Catola. 4C4 Second Vice District Governor Elect Cindy Zhang. 4C4 Second Vice District Governor and President of the Peninsula Council of Lions Clayton Jolly and Lion Mary Kay Jolly. Okay. I did. You guys started clapping before I could get her name out. All right, 4C4, First Vice District Governor and Lion Kevin and President of the Peninsula Veterans Lions Club, Kevin Gass and Tamara Gass. He's going to be your district governor next year. International Director Ken Ibarra. And I have to ask you all to stand, please. It's not a mass. I'm just going to introduce someone. I'd like to introduce our current 4C4 District Governor, John Huey, and Peninsula Immediate Past Chair, Venetia Young. We all know him as Johnny Boy. So thank you. You shall be seated, and dinner is being served. So just head up.
Welcome to the installation ceremony of the recently elected members of the Millbrae Lions Club Board of Directors. We will start with the directors, Lion Ed, Lion Kevin, Lion Mike. And Lion Jeff is not here. Laura, Lion Laura, and Lion Muhammad. Okay, Lion Ed, Kevin, and Mike, which is me, you still have 1 year to serve. Lion Jeff is not here. Lion Laura and Lion Muhammad, you have been elected to serve your club as director for 2 years. With the other officers, will you assist to formulate and execute the policies and new businesses, faithfully attend board meetings, and give unselfishly of your time and effort to advance your club and Lions Clubs International? Will you, as directors, perform all your duties as provided by your club's governing documents to the best of your ability? If so, please answer, I will.
I will.
Good. Congratulations. Say. What you may want to do is just move down to the end of the table. No, you got to stay up here. Okay, next is the historian, past president Bruce, and parliamentarian, past president Gary. Okay. Bruce, you have been elected to serve as your club's historian. According to my trusty desk dictionary, you are a writer or student of history, or you are a person who makes a record of proceedings. Will you as a historian perform all your duties to the best of your ability?
I will.
Yeah. Hey. Lion Gary, you have been elected to serve as your club's parliamentarian. According to my trusty desk dictionary, you have to be an expert in parliamentary procedures, rules, or debate. You know, I have a never unopened Robert's Rules of Order book I can lend you. But will you, as parliamentarian, perform all your duties to the best of your ability? Congratulations. Okay. Lion Wayne. Lion Wayne, you have been elected to serve as, the international calls it, a program coordinator or a director, okay? Will you work to improve the club's meetings by providing programs and speakers of interest to the club members? To ensure meaningful club meetings, will you, as program coordinator or director, perform all your duties to the best of your ability? If so, please answer, I will.
I will.
All right. Lion Tamer, Lion John. You have been elected to serve as Lion Tamer. Will you care for the display and storage of the club's property, flags, gong, and gavel? Will you also serve as sergeant-at-arms and greeter to both guests and members? Will you, as Lion Tamer, perform all your duties as provided by your club's governing documents to the best of your ability? Say, I do.
I do.
I notice on our banner that you have to take up a little sewing. Okay. Tail Twister, Lion John.
I'm John too.
Yes, two Johns. Lion John, you have been elected to serve as Tail Twister. Will you promote harmony, fellowship, fun, and enthusiasm to draw the members together at club meetings, using your best judgment to assist with club administrative fundraising, which means fine people for talking, okay? Will you perform all your duties as provided by your club's governing documents to the best of your ability?
I enthusiastically say I do.
Congratulations. Okay. Our bulletin editor is not here. Lion Juan, not here. Lion Oscar. Oh, here he is. Lion Oscar, you have been elected to serve as the club's assistant treasurer. As such, it is your responsibility to send the quarterly dues billing out, to report to the board at every board meeting how the dues payments are progressing. In other words, anybody that owes money, let us twist their arm a little bit. Will you, as assistant treasurer, perform all your duties to the best of your ability? Say, I will or I do. Okay. Lion Calvin. Lion Calvin, you have been elected to serve as your club's treasurer for 4 more years. Will you manage the collection of club dues and be the custodian of all club receipts and expenditures, giving bond for the faithful fulfillment of duties in keeping with recognized and accepted business and financial practices? Will you, as treasurer, perform all your duties as provided by your club's governing documents to the best of your ability? If so, please answer, I will.
What did you say?
Yeah. You got 4 more years, pal. Secretary Lion John. I was supposed to keep this secret, but Lion John just graduated from the typing and shorthand class. Lion John, you have been elected to serve as your club secretary. Will you maintain all of the general records of the club, submit reports as required by the district and international association, and serve as the liaison between your club, zone, district, and Lions Clubs International? Will you also serve as an active member of the district governor's advisory committee, attending the meetings of your zone? You're going to be a busy guy. Will you, as secretary, perform all your duties as provided by your club's governing documents to the best of your ability?
I will.
Congratulations. Okay, we have the vice presidents, Lion Mike and Lion Ron. Lion Mike is the first vice. Lion Ron is a fill-in second vice. Yeah. You have been elected to serve as vice presidents. Will you, in order of your office and presence, substitute for the president when absent from any club or board of directors meeting and oversee the functioning of such committees as the president may designate? You guys are on the cleanup committees. If requested, will you also serve as an active member of the district's governor advisory committee, attending the meetings of your zone? Will you, as vice presidents, perform all of your duties as provided by your club's governing documents to the best of your ability? Please answer, I will or I do.
I will do a better job this time.
Oh. Oh, than the first time. Okay. Soon to be immediate past president Steve. Yeah. Lion President Steve, I know you're not counting, but you have 6 days left. In 6 days, you will have completed your term as president of the Millbrae Lions Club. But the club is not letting you go out to pasture. You will now become the club's membership chair. You will still be on the board of directors. Your main job will be to help the new president with any questions that he may have. I'm not even going to ask you if you will perform your duties to the best of your ability, because we all know that your work ethics will take care of your duties. President Steve, you had not only a great year, but what I call a fantastic year. Congratulations. Oh, and July 1st, you can use these famous words, when I was president. Thank you, that concludes me. Now Calvin will come up. Helmets and first aid kits.
We give a hand to past District Governor Mike Simonini. So, Lion Geary, you know, this is going to be, this is the first time we've done this. So we're going to do the first annual Millbrae Lions Tour de Millbrae. So before our president can be sworn in, we're going to be his, we're going to escort him around the room like we were on a, like we're Tour de France. So, you know, Gary, have we ever done this before?
No, we've never done this. This is the first annual. So, everybody get your helmets on, get ready. Where is our president? Oh, did he get his bike? Wait a minute, we got him a special bike. You need to get in front there, Bill. We got him a special bike. Lance Armstrong would be jealous of this bike. He may have won even more Tour de France's if he had this bike. It's specially custom made. Lion Wayne has it. I predict that Bill will win many races with this bike. Have fun with this, Bill. If you get on it, you'll never get off.
It's like playing more derby, Bill.
Paul, you stole your bike. You have to ride it and guide us. Okay, ready?
All right. Bikers to their mark. Get ready. Get set. Go. All right.
Come on, you guys. Follow the president. All right. Let's see if there's a breakaway. Lion Gary, have you ever seen this much competition before?
I've never had. This is insane.
Oh, this is really exciting.
They
look at him go. Oh my God.
They may hurt each other.
Who's gonna go first? Is someone gonna break away?
Is there a doctor in the house?
Oh my God. Call the doctor.
Call the doctor, call a nurse.
Oh my God. This is too exciting.
Alright.
Wow, look at this peloton. They're really pushing them forward. That's what it takes, the whole team.
One more lap. We gotta do another lap. Another lap. Another lap, come on. We gotta do another lap. Come on, let's go. One more year, Bill, one more year. Come on, I think they're tired. Wayne, they're getting a little tired. I think they're heading to the
Alps. They're hitting the hills, they're hitting the Pyrenees. But I think they can make it, they can push the president forward. Look at that teamwork.
Hey, we got a strangler. A straggler, I meant. Sorry, he probably is a strangler too.
I think it's the competition.
It is a competition. All right, we got a winner. We got a winner. Second place goes to Oscar. Third place goes to Calvin. All right, thank you, gentlemen. Well, that was a little bit of fun. I think they burned a couple of calories on that one. And now, really, this is the highlight of the evening, where we get to induct the new president. So I'm going to hand this over to past president Calvin.
Thank you, Lion. Past president Gary Pellegrini, give a hands up! Yay! Woo! I am out of breath. Let's get the person of the hour to come up here.
What? Keep my helmet off. I thought we were going to...
Oh, thank you. All right. Wow. You know, Bill, it's hard to believe that 18 years ago, when we were just 25 years old, we stood here in this room as Cub Scout parent leaders, providing our annual PAC 355 update to our charter organization. It is my honor to install you, my dear longtime friend, our next Lions journey as president. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right. Lion Bill Meyer, you have been elected to serve as our president of our legendary club. You will be its chief Mojo Executive Officer and will be expected to preside all club and board of directors meetings. It is your duty to appoint administrative and project activity committees in accordance with the Lions International Standard Organization Plan and to act as an ex officio, whatever that means, member of each of these committees. With your vice presidents, you shall see that these committees will be high performing and also have a lot of fun. Your records of achievement will be history and will be compared with the records of other presidents for many years to come. Your club members are the keys to your success. Now is the time to continue to fine tune and execute your Millbrae Lions roadmap and take the steps to elevate your club's mojo in every possible way so it is the de facto movers and shakers within our community and its inspiration to all volunteers, organization, District 4C4, Lions International, and most important, deliver impactful value to the many wonderful communities we serve. Will you, as president, perform your duties to the best of your ability?
I will. Yeah!
I will. Whoa, good. Lion President Bill, as a wise Uncle Ben once said to his nephew, Peter Parker, "With great power comes great responsibilities." Yeah. I proudly hand this gavel as a token of our club's confidence in you and your symbol of authority. And now, Lion President Bill Meyer, it is my personal pleasure to congratulate you upon the honor your club has conferred and elect you as this 86th Millbrae Lions Club President and Chief Mojo Executive. Now please turn and face your members and guests. Will all members and guests please rise and welcome our 86th Millbrae Lions President, Bill Meyer! Dun, 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 dun. Okay, I'm gonna hand it back over to Lion, meet the past president.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah, bell. Your bell.
Okay, Lady Carol is now going to put Lion President Bill's president's pin on his lapel. She can get it out. Drum roll, please.
Out.
Out.
Go for it.
Yeah, he has nerve endings in his clothing, sure. Yeah. Yeah.
That's the latest technology, right?
Look at that. All right, yay! Lion, Vice President Gary?
Okay, when we asked Bill, what theme did you want at your installation? He said, "I want a rock and roll theme." And he said, and I said, "Well, what do you want to do?" He said, "Well, I want German food." And he also said that he wants to play some rock and roll. So what we did is we asked a couple of Lions to join us and a couple of my good friends to join us. So we're going to go over there and play some music for you. But Bill has a quick speech first.
Is this where I speech or I tell about the band? Well, you can sit down. Are we going to the band right now? All right, we're going to go to the band first. All right, all right, all right, all right. Okay, look. I wrote all these notes about what I'm going to say tonight. I was going to read my notes. I had a conversation earlier this evening. Where is Lion Tom Williams? Lion Tom and I had this conversation about, public speaking is the number one people fear the most. I go, yeah, I got to speak in front of the group. I got my notes. I go, I wish I could just wing it. And then we said, well, I think I'm just going to wing it. That's what I'm going to do. I'm not going to read my notes. But anyway, I want to say thanks to everyone who's here. I want to say thanks again to the committee who put this together. I'm humbled, excited about this coming year. I'm luckily, like, at least half this room are past presidents, so I have lots of people to lean on to help me out through this year. And I do want to say thank you to Steve for being the role model for this past year. You know, fantastic. Yeah. So I see if I can tell this story. I have a little story about how I got here, how I got to be a Lion. So yeah, a little story here. About 27 years ago, whatever it was, 1997, Lady Carol and I are living in the city in an apartment. Let's start a family. Let's find a community where the schools are good. We end up, long story short, we end up in Millbrae with a fixer-upper house. We're pregnant with our first child. We got involved in the community over time. You know, when you first it was like transactional. We got to buy a house. We're going to start a family. Let's get a minivan. You know, all the stuff that we did, all the, you know, the process. But, and then we got involved in, with the schools and baseball and things like that, where you get involved in the community with your kids. And then, you know, with this fixer-upper house, one day we need some plumbing work. And a guy by the name of Jim Kotchik came by, and we selected him to do our plumbing work. And he was a Millbrae Lion. Super nice guy. He's doing work on our house. I'm chatting with him, and he's telling me about the Lions Club. He wasn't trying to get me to join or anything like that. He was just saying how wonderful it is, and he got some boys. I forget how the boys, you know, Anthony and Gino, how old they were at that time, whatever, 20-some years, 27 years ago, or whatever it was. I thought, yeah, someday I'll join the Lions. It sounds really nice, but not now. I got to fix up her house. I got kids on the way, so it doesn't work out. So fast forward a little in some time, and our kids are joining Scouts, and we're at the very first meeting. Calvin, I mean, that's the first time I ever laid eyes on a 6'5" Chinese guy. So Calvin's taller than me. So Calvin, we're sitting around, we're, you know, our kids are playing, goofing around, and the new parents are sitting in a circle. And the Cub Scout leader at the time comes over and says, "Well, which one of you is going to be the leader?" And so we're like, you know, I don't know about me. I finally, somebody's got to do it. So I said, "I'll do it if somebody does it with me." And Calvin said, "Okay, I'll do it with you." So that was the first time, you know, I met Calvin, and so we started working together. That was just for the Tiger Cubs. The first year of Scouts. So we were both the leaders for that first year. Next thing you know, like the following year, I'm the Cub Master and he's the committee chair. So we're now at the top of the top of the rung. And it's very similar to Lions, where in that the president and like the secretary almost for the Cub Scouts. So fast forward. Then we asked the current leaders before we actually became full-time leaders or the top leaders. We asked the current leaders, like, "Oh, we're chartered by the Millbrae Lions. What does that mean?" And they really didn't have much to say, and I don't think they were very connected with the Lions. So we were like, "Well, let's go talk to the Lions." And you guys were meeting here at that time. So we came up in our uniforms, you know, not nerdy at all. We were in our scout, you know, just like the kids here earlier. And we did a slideshow presentation about all, you know, what we're doing. And the Lions Club just welcomed us with open arms and an open checkbook, too, by the way. So that was, you know, and then sometime later, I don't know, Calvin and I talked about it. Well, we should join the Lions, and I don't know all the details, but that was 17 years ago that I joined the Lions Club the same day as Calvin did. So we've been together for all this time. That's why, you know, Calvin inducted me. Let's see, where am I going from here? So where's my notes? No notes. Yeah, they're on the floor. So then we became Lions, and here we are 17 years later. Oh, I know what I was going to say. I've been asking the club management for years for a promotion. I finally got a promotion 17 years later. I mean, some people get promoted quicker than others, I guess. It must be my performance and a raise. I need a raise, Calvin. I'll be on you about this. A percentage raise of nothing. That's right. Give me 5%. Yeah. So anyway, thank you all. I'm just very excited. I'm humbled to be the president of this club. It's amazing. The 86th individual president. Never had a repeat president. It's just amazing. Of course, by the time somebody gets comfortable doing it next, So maybe I'll get comfortable doing it after, you know, after a year, and then the next one comes in. Last story I wanted to tell was about how this band thing, you know, Gary started it, Lion Past President Gary started it, but, you know, we were planning for this meeting, and it's like, oh, do you want a theme? I don't know. I got lots of hobbies, you know, I cycle. I guess that's how that came up. I like to cycle. I like to play. I play in a band. It's like, okay, let's have a rock and roll theme. And you could get your band to play. Oh, that'd be fun. You know, I'm comfortable. I know all those songs and everything. But our band should play. And then three of my bandmates couldn't make it. So then I asked, then I talked to Gary. Well, Gary plays music. Maybe just me and Gary could do a little thing. You know, it's a rock and roll thing. And then so Gary says, well, we should probably have a drummer. So Bob over here is our drummer now. He didn't join it. So yeah, okay, we have a drummer. But hey, wait a minute. Lynn and Randy, past presidents both, they're singers. They love to sing. They sing in choirs. And maybe they could be backup singers. Yeah, let's do that. Now they're going to be our backup singers tonight. And then he says, well, we probably should have another guitarist. Okay, let's do another guitarist. So now we have this band. We call ourselves the Cool Cats. Get it? The Cool Cats. So the Cool Cats are going to play about 8 songs tonight. Hope you'll stick around and listen to us. This is just another thing for me to get nervous about tonight, because I played with these folks. I did 2 practices with them. Gary selected the songs, pretty simple songs, so hopefully I don't mess up too much. But I play bass guitar, and so... Yeah, so we're gonna do it. We're gonna do it now? All right. After this, then, there's an award ceremony. So just, I think we got 8 songs we're gonna play for you, and maybe you can sing along, or maybe you can dance, whatever.
The star of the evening, we got Phil, was that Bill Lennon? Oh, Bill Meyer, on the drum and bass.
Take the ponytail, man.
Start out with an old Chuck Berry song, because all of Chuck Berry songs are old. It was a tea wedding in the old folks' whistle well. Oh, Chuck Berry to John Denver. How about that? You know, we got to please everybody. So.
Thank you. Take a load off, Penny. Here's an old one from Tommy Two Tone.
Yeah.
Make you mine, taste your lips like wine. Thank you.
Thank you.
Cool
Pants. That's all we know.
Okay, if I could have everyone's attention. I'm a politician, and if it doesn't quiet, I'll talk that much longer. Oh dear. All right, I was told absolutely no speeches. I am actually here. We've got Councilwoman Gina Pappin, Councilman Anders Thung, and City Manager Tom Williams. All of us, by the way, are Lions. We actually are. All five city council members are Lions, so. You talk about influence, but I'm actually here to say thank you, first of all, to all of the Lions and all of the Lady Lions and all of the family members of the Lions, because they put in a lot of time, and all of the family members, you and the Lions are such huge assets to the city of Millbrae. So with that, I thank you all. I'm sure the councilwoman here, we are just grateful to have you. You're a huge part of the city of Millbrae. Now with that, I get the honor of embarrassing almost past president, Steve. So Steve, if you could please join me. It is the city of Millbrae's honor to celebrate your year of great service and all the new things that happened, even as we come out of COVID, and how grateful I am for all of the times I call you and say, hey, Lion Steve, can we do Juneteenth? Hey, Lion Steve, we've got the 75th birthday coming up. Can you help us? Hey, Lion Steve, our Leos are doing blah, 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 which you've all heard about. Anyway, we have a commendation from the city, and we're just very grateful. I don't know if Anders is still here, but we get a council picture up here. We are thankful to soon-to-be past President Steve, and the best of lucks to incoming President Bill, and to the board, and to the Lions. Thank you. That wasn't too long of a speech, huh? Okay. You want that paycheck for 4th of July.
You're on the clock. Steve, don't go far. Yeah. This is a commendation. The Board of Supervisors of San Mateo County, State of California, commends and honors Steve Henderson as the outgoing 85th president of the Millbrae Lions Club. And it's signed by, Dave Pine, Nolia Corzo, Ray Muller, Warren Slocum. Oh, I pay that guy taxes every year. And David Canepa. So there you go, sir. All right, we're not done yet. And the State of California Senate Certification of Recognition, Lion Steve Henderson, Millbrae Lions Club, is signed by Senator Josh Becker, 13th District, to Steve Henderson. There we go. Find a place on your wall to put these, because I did. And California Legislator Assembly Certification of Recognition presented to President Steve Henderson, Millbrae Lions Club 22-23. This is from Assembly Member 21st District, Diane Pappin. June 24th, 2023. Presented with gratitude and recognition of the Millbrae Lions Club, outgoing President Steve Henderson, your leadership and commitment to the community is commendable. Best wishes on your future endeavors. Did a good job, Steve.
Okay, Steve. On behalf of the Millbrae School District, I, Frank, Lynn Ferrario, Karen Chin, we're all here to say thank you for all that you have done. Not just us. Many years that we've known each other, whether it's baseball, whether it's Spring Valley, whether it's whatever it is, for the past 18 years that we've known each other, like, you've gone above and beyond for the Millbrae community. So we do really appreciate it. Just because you're not president anymore in 6 days, that you'll be around the Millbrae communities doing whatever you can to make it best for our children of Millbrae. Because as a school district, everything we do, everything we, you know, say, our belief is about the children of the Millbrae School District. So.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. So they gave me the mic here. Steve and I worked a lot this year. And I got to tell you, there's a lot of presidents in this Lions room right now. A lot of great presidents that are sitting here. And Steve went right up there to that level with all you people in the room because he set the bar this year. Everything that we did in Millbrae was an extreme success. We all had a lot of fun doing it. The community loved us doing it. So on behalf of the Millbrae School District and our superintendent, Debbie French, let me say her name right, we really admire you. We love your leadership. You're part of the Millbrae community, and good luck with everything that you do. Thank you so much for your service.
Say one more thing. We love you, Steve, but Bill Meyers, we're so lucky to be as a school district to be working with you. We've known each other, you and Carol Meyers at Spring Valley. We've done so much together. So I'm really looking forward to working with you as the next president of the Millbrae Lions as a school district. So.
Okay, and finally for Steve, I think this might be it. For Steve, Lions International presented to Steve Henderson in appreciation for outstanding dedicated service and exceptional leadership as president of the Lions Club of Millbrae, California, 2022 to 2023, from number 86 to number 85. And thank you all for tolerating the band. It was great. Thanks a lot. Are you next? Who's MC now?
Let's give Steve's pick. Okay,
so this is a very special pin that's given to the past president. And Lion in Service, Cindy, is going to pin our past president, Steve. Don't lose it, that's an expensive pin. Okay, thank you, Lion Steve, everybody. Yeah. Okay, so this is the most important part. This is where Lion Steve really shows his appreciation to the club.
Well, so I want to say how much of a tremendous honor it is to serve the community. And I have to start by thanking my wife, partner in service, Cindy Henderson, for serving along with me. And start out, and I'll just say that when you commit to serve in a community service organization, particularly like the Lions, it's all in, and so our whole family has been involved. For those of you who were at my installation last year, you saw my son, John, and so proud of him. But it's been a fantastic year of service, and this club, you know, I am going to grab some notes, and I'm going to tell you just, and it's not going to take me very long. I promise not to go on too long, but I want to say that we're literally the most dynamic club in the district. I'm going to tell you that right now. We are number one, period. It's not bragging if it's true. Okay, so it's true. When I was looking at the notes and I talked to Mariah Tucker and she goes, I just want you to know, 2,900 service hours, okay? 2,900 service hours. 6,500 people served directly. 24 service activities, we gave away directly $43,000. We received $75,000 in fundraising. We've had an incredibly busy year. What I want to say is thank you to the everyday individuals that make up this club and serve the community. I have been involved in baseball. My kids have been involved in scouting. My kids have gone through the schools. And in each of those pursuits, the Lions are deeply involved. And so when I was thinking about how I could be impactful, I decided I would join the Lions Club, and I convinced friends of mine to also join. And like John LaDuca, who is probably number one in convincing his friends to join, we all really, really feel that it's important to give back, and we've all taken our turn. So when it was my chance to go through the chairs, that's what I did. And I'm inspired by the opportunity to serve alongside you. And, you know, my mantra this year was alignment and empowerment. Like, I was thinking about people getting excited about what they care about and forming relationships, deeper relationships with people who also really care about the community, and doing everything we can to be sure that we were meeting the needs. Now, I'm a career educator, right? I've been teaching for 33 years. I teach high school, I teach U.S. history, and I coach football. I'm an old school guy. So for me, trust is earned. And I care most deeply about kids. That's what I care about. Now, no disrespect to you all, but in my community and in my life, for me, it matters most to see that we are doing our best by the children that are in our community. And I think that for this organization, that's what we are about. So I've done everything I could over the course of the year to be sure that we could make things happen and continue to keep it rolling in a positive direction for the kids, because they're the future, and that's what's most important. And I feel like over the course of the year, that has not taken a tremendous amount of effort, because there are so many people over the many projects that we have done that feel the same way. So I'm really grateful and very, very thankful for your service along my side. So thank you. I'm going to quickly, there's a couple of people who aren't here that I have singled out for awards. First of all is Juan Gámez. Juan's in Scotland right now. Juan was our tail twister extraordinaire this year. I mean, for those of you who have been at meetings, we meet here, and Juan would always check in with me and kind of talk about some of the cool stuff that he got. And the raffle was always kind of an exciting thing, because Juan was into it, you know, and he was making sure that there was cool stuff for people to get, and there was a lot of energy behind it. So just for the fact that he served with such energy and passion, I recognized him for extraordinary service, so I got a plaque for him, and he's not here to receive it, but I'm going to make sure he gets it when he gets back from Scotland. So congratulations to Juan. Another person that I want to recognize for extraordinary service is also not here. It's Wilson Yee. So Wilson, those of you who know Wilson, Wilson is just a doer. Now, a lot of us are that way, and that's kind of the people that we attract. Wilson is a guy that gets up at, you know, 4 o'clock in the morning and runs he's a general manager of a Lenardi's grocery store, and just an outstanding individual. And the guy, he hustles, and he gives great energy to the community, and there are just so many events that we have had. So the family holiday assistance would not have happened without Wilson Yee. Contributing sandwiches for the golf tournament would not have happened without Wilson Yee. The lobster feed that we had, the success of the lobster feed, getting the produce for that, would not have happened without Wilson. It's just, he's the kind of guy that basically just says, what needs to happen? What do I need to do? Tell me where to show up, and I'm ready to go. And so just from those things, and just also just his everyday willingness to go and do above and beyond, he's that kind of guy. I wanted to give him special recognition, so thanks to Wilson. The next person who I want to recognize is here, and this is a person who just does, and I don't think really expects a lot of recognition for it. This is a person that basically, without him, we wouldn't have the ambiance and the success of the meetings that we do have, and would not be able to be received with the kind of grace that we are, the kind of energy that we bring in these meetings and the feelings that we have about being here to think about ways to serve the community. None of that happens without this guy. When there's an emergency and things seem to be falling apart, this guy is super calm, and all of a sudden, everything is fine. So I want to give special recognition to this person for outstanding service this year, Ed Musa. Ed, come on up. My next award. So this person is incredibly active and super passionate about everything they do. They have served at the district level they've just made things happen at the district level in a different way. They ask a lot of questions and they demand answers and action and excellence, and they're the kind of person that thinks that no means maybe, and they also deeply advocate on behalf of kids. And in our club, what we found out is that literally in Lions International, our Leos program has been recognized at such a high level in back-to-back years that they're really, how high is high? We don't know, but we do know that this year, several of the Leos received presidential medals of honor. The recognition that the Leos have received, the way this person functions at the district level and at the local level, anytime we have an event, we are always thinking about, how can we make sure that we have enough people to serve and help us out? And it always comes down to, can we get the Leos to help? And this person has managed to build ways where there could be additional volunteers, and excellence has more than doubled the size of the organization since he's been involved. It's just been an incredible journey, and I want to invite International Director Ken Ibar up here to talk a little bit more about this award, because it is of one of the highest honors that the Lions Club has to give. So I'm going to give this over to Ken.
Thank you, Lion President Steve. Just a note. You say that the Millbrae Lions are arguably the best in the district. Lion Amy and I have traveled the country and Canada for the last 2 years. We've seen Lions in North America. So you're selling yourself short for saying the district. Millbrae Lions are probably one of the best clubs that we have witnessed in this country. And I know there's a few gray hairs here, so I can say that because I've been around for a while. I'm proud to be a Lion for 31 years, and yes, I do miss a lot of Lions that are not here, a lot of Millbrae Lions, and they looking down on you right now and very proud. And so the awards that you're giving out and the new leadership that has come forward that I've seen over the last few years, it's remarkable. Yes, you are taking care of the Millbrae community, but we're not just talking about filling spots. We're just not talking about, people with titles and things. You are all hardworking and you get the job done, and you do new stuff. And they're always, you know, if I wasn't around much, I mean, I wouldn't recognize half the people here because you're constantly bringing in new members. And it's great because some clubs just keep rehashing them, and you've been doing it now time and again for 86 years, and you should be commended for that. This award, Melvin Jones Award, it's recognition. And what it is, it's for $1,000, you get to be part of the fellowship. You're the Lions Clubs International Foundation, your foundation, your charity arm that has donated and taken care of millions of people and donated millions of dollars throughout the world. So to be part of this is very special. It's not necessarily an award, it's a recognition. But the fact that you, Lion President, are selecting this individual is very special because exemplifies one of the highest awards that can be bestowed on a lion, Melvin Jones Award. And so we do this a lot with Lion Amy being your district coordinator for LCIF. And there's a lot of money, and there's a lot of people sitting in this room now that have been very generous, you know, over the years. And I just want to welcome this lion into the fellowship.
I'll let you announce it while I pick it up. Lion Michael Kelly.
Heavy metal.
Yeah. Anyway, yeah. And
heavy
I have
metal, rock and roll.
Comes with the smallest pin because it's on the bottom of my pocket.
We need to get on this.
Yeah,
there you go.
Welcome to the fellowship.
Yes. Picture, guys. One, two, three.
Over here. One, two, three.
Okay, look at me. Look at me. All right. Beautiful.
Yeah. Thank you, everybody.
Way to go, Michael.
All right, last but not least, thanks for your patience, and I know we're going to get to the dancing, so boy, I'm going to. So finally, so for every person that really sets out to get something done, you really have to have, it's about relationships, and you have to have people that you can deeply trust that you know are going to have your back. And I have learned that really, this is an extraordinary room of people that cares deeply and understands that sense of commitment that you need. And I've learned that I can trust a lot of you to really make sure that things happen. There's one person in this room that literally, when you think about Millbrae machines, this person is super integral in that. I mean, it's if they're not really dedicated and functioning and working on that, it's not as successful of an event. It's a pretty good event, but there's no way it's as successful if this person's not involved. You think about the golf tournament. You said, we need certain things to happen for the golf tournament. Oh, I think I know someone. And a couple calls later, the golf tournament is a little better because, and there's some different things going on different holes because this person's involved. You think about baseball. And there's a huge baseball tournament going on. If you want to catch some good baseball in the next couple days, any field here in Millbrae, anytime, all day tomorrow, all the playoff and championship games from 8U to 16U are happening in Millbrae. Over 40 teams have been invited to the tournament. It makes our town look great. A lot of people would love to see you there. But this person, without their dedication and energy, none of that stuff that's going on in baseball would be happening. They also quietly give to the club, and I'm not going to talk about numbers or anything, but they care very deeply because they understand that the impact that this club has is significant. So when they joined, they rolled their sleeves up immediately, and really very little of what I've been able to achieve, what we've been able to achieve together, would have happened without this person marching alongside. So my line of the year is Kevin O'Neill. Jimmy. Oh, we got to ring the bells before the music starts. Hey, Bill, we got to ring the bells. The actual meeting part is adjourned. We're just going to party now. Okay, so I want to explain. I'll let Bill, you want to explain?
Can I just say, I wish I was eloquent as him. That's all I have.
So the ringing of the bells, we're going to simultaneously, let's make sure we're ringing the right one. I get you your, you take your gavel. Holy smokes, I better make sure I'm hitting the right one.
Congratulations, both of you.
Perfect. Hey, Lion Jimmy's got the music going next door. Let's dance.